Our team name is R.E.S.P.O.N.D., and we chose this name because every letter in the word R.E.S.P.O.N.D. can stand for something that you can do to be prepared for emergencies. Here we have R is resist your fear, E is evaluate the situation, S is secure essentials, P for protect yourself, O for organize gear, N for never give up, and finally D for develop.
If you guys go home and create these plans with your family and everyone knows what to do, then in case of emergency, the more that you practice it, the easier it's going to be, and it's just going to come to your mind and you won't have to think about things.
Some of the things you guys can do, you can go home and talk with your parents about where these things are at, and you can get the kit put together, and then you guys can rehearse like we've talked about with Joe. So some of the other things that you want in this kit would be things like flashlights. Well, how do flashlights work? There you go. Now I'm going to turn over to Brad, and we're going to go through a little exercise about things that could be in your kit, or maybe you should take with you, or maybe you shouldn't, and you guys are going to let us know what you think would be good to have in your kit and what wouldn't be.
Water.
And just like Dave said earlier, how many days of water should you have?
Three
days, yeah. So I think this is pretty self-explanatory. Who thinks you can live longer without, what do you think you can do? Live longer without food or without water? Live longer without food. So water and bandages are probably the most vital thing you can have in your emergency kit. So we'll put this outside. All right, now this is where it's open for discussion. And the last class convinced me that this should be in the kit. So how about this?
No!
You're in a safe place when something happens, like a tornado or something like a flood. You're in a safe place. You want to get out of a safe place at some point, but you want to make sure it's safe before you get out. So things you can do.
First step was create a plan. So that's important to go over with all your families. Make sure you know what you're going to do in case of emergency. Now our second step was prepare a
kit.
Exactly, and we just went over. So you guys need to remember all that stuff that we put in our kit. And whenever you go home today, you can talk with your families about, you know, we need to get something and be prepared. And the third one was listen for
instruction
and information.
Who can tell me the three steps of being prepared? The little girl in the orange?
Create a plan, prepare a kit, listen for information.
Very good. Good job, Will. All right, and how many days worth of supplies should you have in order to be prepared? Thank you guys for listening to all of us. And again, your teachers will have information you can give your parents. What do we say?
Thank you!
When I was a little boy, I swore that I would change the world. When I grew up, nothing else would be enough. I see it every day. We set off for a save and lose ourselves.